I have to admit a pet peeve of mine. Poorly transitioned ad segments, like for Squarespace, this video sponsor. From websites and online stores to marketing tools and analytics, Squarespace is the all-in-one platform to build a beautiful online presence and run your business. Okay, for real though. A minor pet peeve of mine is when someone asks me how to paint the color blue or leather. And by minor, I mean I'm raging on the inside, but I don't want to let you know that because you'll think I'm a prick. Oh, whoops. The question itself is absolutely harmless, albeit a little misguided. There are literally infinite ways to paint everything, and for once since 2017, I'm using the word literally as it's intended to be used. Today we're exploring the endless ocean of options that is how to paint the color yellow, but really we'll only ever be scratching the surface. Here's my situation. I started painting a dark Eldar army in 2016, and because I always need to be different, I painted mine yellow. They look fine, but the road I took to get there was anything but efficient. Basically, it was Warhammer TV regurgitation. I began with a black undercoat because everything starts there, obviously. I applied a yellow base coat over black because I hate myself, followed by a Seraphim Sepia wash because that's always the second step in a GW scheme, followed of course by reapplying my base coat everywhere other than the recesses because base coating yellow the first time was so much fun that I had to do it again, tailed by a yellow highlight, and finally of course 1 to 2 layers of edge highlighting. I know I'm ragging on this kind of paint scheme, there's absolutely nothing wrong with it, but for me personally, I'll never finish an army with a scheme like this, so changes need to be made. I'd like to make a yellow recipe for the armor of my Druhakari army that leverages the fact that I own an airbrush now, or several, so let's start slinging paint and see what works. I bought some pre-assembled and pre-painted Cabalite Warriors from my local game store for $1 apiece, which will make for some perfect test models after a little stripping. Finding all the yellow colors I have allows me to kind of imagine the full landscape of what yellow can be. So first, I got out all my yellow colors for some inspiration. Okay, first on the list, let's test some contrast paint and other similar products. With a warm white undercoat, I painted on several offerings from GW and from Scale 75's instant paint range on a single miniature targeting different parts of the model for a direct comparison. After using these products a couple times, I've discovered what I think is the key to getting good results with them. They tend to dry pretty fast, so I like to work on one small part of the model at a time, applying a large amount of the substance and then with a clean brush, wicking away large pools of color from flat surfaces or surfaces that are facing upright. This ensures a coverage that's closer to even and nice dark recessed lines. The real key is just to work on as large a part as the dry time of the product you're using allows for. The last step in every single test I do today will be some kind of edge highlight. While this step is something of a time sink, I'm fairly comfortable with the technique and can do it pretty quickly. I tested 6 different applications of translucent paint, and of all 6, I think Nazdrag Yellow from GW got closest to what I had in mind, and was also pretty close to what I originally did. It's worth mentioning that I don't need this scheme to look identical to the old one. I think the idea that every single soldier in an army needs to look the same is kind of silly. I think variation will look good, but I guess we'll find out when the army is painted. Okay, that was pretty basic, now let's get a little funkier. I want to test the effect of several undercoats. With a test model, I painted one half purple and the other half red. Then, over that, I applied a warm zenithal light. When that was all dry, I applied more Nazdrag yellow, the contrast paint that I like the most. The idea here is that not only will we get the recess shading from a contrast paint as it collects more in the recesses, creating a darker line, but also the yellow over top of this fairly bright warm white. As expected, the red creates a richer golden yellow, and the purple gives us a more desaturated, interesting look. With a similar approach in mind, I do an undercoat of green and blue with a cold white zenithal light on a third model. Instead of using contrast paint this time around, I instead applied a yellow-green mixture with my airbrush and then a dark blue oil wash applied carefully to the recesses. Often products that claim to do multiple jobs are often worse at those respective jobs in exchange for convenience. So I was loosely testing that idea here, replacing contrast paint for ink supply through an airbrush and an oil wash. Of course, I ended each of these steps with an edge highlight. What I learned from these initial tests was that if I want the yellow to show through at the end, I need to go a little overboard with the white zenithal highlight. Before moving on to our next test, let's hear a brief word from today's sponsor, Squarespace. I don't have a personal gallery for my miniature painting art, so when Squarespace reached out to me to sponsor a video, I took this as an opportunity to use their platform to build a dedicated gallery for myself. A gallery like this is useful for a number of reasons. For those who don't know what miniature painting is, I'm looking at you, Aunt Amy, this shows them in a succinct, beautiful way. Importing images and dealing with alignment is made easy, and all the while creating a website that just looks awesome. It's important that your gallery show your work while also being functional and beautiful itself. If I need to see a bigger resolution of this miniature so I can see the creamy blends, it's as simple as double clicking. If you want to save some fat stacks on making a miniature art gallery for yourself, head to squarespace.com/miniac to save 10% off of your first purchase of a website or domain using the code MINIAC at checkout. All right, back to my yellow tests. Let's get even funkier. Chartreuse, or a highlighter yellow, is another version of yellow that could work with the common narrative of Dark Eldar being all poisonous and whatnot. Starting with that as my base coat, I washed the right side with Magos Purple, thinned down with a contrast medium to turn it into more of a wash, and the left side with Vulpus Purple, also thinned down. Of the two tests here, I think I prefer the Magos version. Okay, let's try some dry brushing. With a brown base coat, I started to dry brush on an ochre tone, followed by a lighter yellow tone. I'm beginning to notice a bit of a pattern with my previous tests. When you begin with a darker color and then apply lighter tones on top, you have to be quite liberal with your application of midtone, which is the color you want the mini to read as in the end. For instance, if I want this Dark Eldar to read as ochre, I would have needed to dry brush way more than I did, but that's okay, now we know. With that lesson in mind, let's try a version where I apply my target midtone as a base coat and then shade it afterwards. The shading I used for this step was violet ink. I then applied a recessed shade with a contrast paint instead of an oil wash this time, applying it carefully to the recesses. This took a lot longer than any kind of wash that I previously did, so I'll likely not do this in the final paint scheme. Trying to shade the mini after there's a midtone on it is a little more challenging than applying a highlight to a dark model, so I think I'll stick with the latter approach, being mindful of how much bright color I put on the model. Not every single test needs to be an entirely new approach. You might take a similar approach as previously, but apply different colors. On this model, I tried an oil wash where I applied it all over the mini without spending time to carefully apply it to the deepest, darkest corners. I then later cleaned it up with a sponge and some mineral spirits, testing out the time investment, but also the end result of both approaches. For what it's worth, I prefer carefully applying the oil wash in the first place versus cleaning it up afterwards. As I'm hoping you can see, there are really endless roads you could take to achieve the color yellow, and really any color or effect you're going for. Okay, with everything I learned from my tests, it's time to come up with a final scheme. I'm going to start with magenta because I like the look of a magenta undercoat with yellow. Next, I'll apply a zenithal highlight with an off-white yellow, making sure to apply a lot of it, and not just where it hits if I'm spraying from above, but also making sure to get under the gun where his torso is and other key areas. Then, with pure white, I'll bump up his shoulders, chest, and head. That'll be the last of our undercoat steps. With yellow ink, I'll spray the armor, trying to avoid the cloth elements of the Cabalite Warrior, as those later will be cream, and if I can avoid them now, it'll help later. I have to be somewhat mindful of how much yellow ink I apply because the more I apply, the deeper and richer the color becomes. I then apply an oil wash carefully to the recesses of magenta and Payne's Gray mixed together to create a deep, warm purple color. Lastly, I apply an edge highlight, and fast forwarding through all the other bits, I have a completed warrior in 38 minutes and 41 seconds. That isn't incredibly fast, but with a few steps reorganized and maybe some left off entirely, I should be able to get this down to 30 minutes, which is an amount of time I'm happy to spend on each warrior, and it's way more efficient than my old scheme. I spent around 15 to 20 hours exclusively testing color schemes. I can't say if that's worth it for you, but for me, it totally was. I'm not really a fan of the color yellow, so being able to try out a bunch of approaches to find the one that I like gives me confidence when trying to paint the rest of my army, as opposed to painting my army and being unhappy with it. What about the original issue? How do you ask a question like, how do I paint yellow? Well, if you want to ask someone that question, give them some more context. Maybe you want to do a sickly green yellow, or a rich red orange yellow, or a weathered yellow. Whatever your question, the more context you provide, the more you narrow this infinitely large color ocean we're all swimming in, and the better your answer will be. That's going to do it for this one, guys. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you want to watch more videos that are similar to this one, I'll have them linked at the end of this video. If you like the channel and you want to support it, there are a number of ways that you can do it, namely a Patreon campaign with a bunch of fun rewards, like a Discord server where you and I can hang out any day of the week and talk about your miniature painting projects, or how to paint the color orange. You can also buy hobby tools that I recommend in the description below. All those links are affiliate links. And you can also buy the Duchess and the digital course that I have for it. That's a miniature vampire that I produce and make a course for it. You can watch and learn how to paint the box art like I did. Subscribe or die! And most importantly, don't forget to paint my minis!